नमस्कार चिल्ड्रन, इन द कंटिन्यूएशन ऑफ प्रीवियस क्लास टुडे वील डू द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटीज। सो हेयर इज द फर्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज शॉर्टेज ऑफ कैपिटल। इट सफर्स फ्रॉम शॉर्टेज ऑफ कैपिटल एज इट इज यूजुअली फॉर्म्ड बाय पीपल विद लिमिटेड मीन्स। कोऑपरेटिव्स ऑलवेज हैव वेरी लिमिटेड रिसोर्सेज as the main finance source is the capital contributions from its members only. Low rate of return and one man one vote policy also discourage members from investing more capital. The second limitation is inefficient management. Cooperative societies managed by elected members who may not be competent and experienced. Moreover, it cannot afford to employ expert and experienced people at high salaries. Due to limited finance and voluntary services, cooperatives cannot employ individuals with expertise to manage the affairs professionally. The third limitation is lack of motivation. Members are not inclined to put their best efforts, as there is no direct link between efforts and reward. In cooperatives, there is no direct link between the efforts and rewards. That's why the profits earned are shared amongst all the members. Due to lack of incentive for efficient working members, do not put in their best efforts. The next limitation is lack of secrecy. Its affairs are openly discussed in its meetings, which makes it difficult to maintain secrecy. Because the Cooperative Societies Act requires members to discuss all its operations in the meetings and disclose all decisions, therefore maintaining secrecy is just not possible. The next limitation is excessive government control. It suffers from excessive rules and regulations of the government. It has to get its accounts audited by the auditor and has to submit a copy of its account to registrar. Cooperative societies are required to follow these all rules and regulations related to submission and auditing of accounts. This reduces the freedom of operation also. The last limitation is conflict among members. The members are from different sections of society with different viewpoints. Sometimes when some members become rigid, the result is conflict. Difference of opinion and individual interest may also lead to conflicts amongst members. And as a result, the welfare motive may get dominated by personal interest and benefits. So these are the limitations of cooperative society. Now the next topic is types of cooperative societies. Here six types are there, one by one. I'm going to tell you. The first one is consumers cooperative society. It formed to protect the interest of consumers. It seeks to eliminate middlemen by establishing a direct link with the producers. It purchases goods of daily consumption directly from the manufacturer or the wholesaler and sells them to the members at reasonable price. This consumer cooperative society are formed to protect the interest of consumers. The goods are purchased in bulk. Bulk means in more quantity from wholesalers, and then those goods will be sold to the members. Bulk buying and elimination of middlemen reduces the cost of products. If society earns profit in the process of sale, it is distributed amongst members in their capital contribution or purchases made by individual members. So, main thing is there. The society aim is to provide the good quality products to its member at reasonable prices. The next cooperative society is Producers Cooperative Society. The main aim is to help small producers who cannot easily collect various items of production and face some problem in marketing. These societies purchase raw materials, tools, equipments, and other items in large quantity and provide these things to their members at reasonable price. So the main aim is to protect the interest of small producers. These societies provide raw materials, equipments, and other items to the members at cheaper rates. The output may be sold by the members of society and the profit earned is shared by members on the basis of their contributions towards total production or sale of goods. The society helps its members to fight against big producers with better bargaining powers. Okay, so this is the second type of cooperative society, producers cooperative society. Now, the third type of cooperative society is marketing cooperative society. In this type of society, it performs various marketing functions such as transportation, warehousing, packing, grading, marketing research for the benefits of its members. The production of different members is pooled together and sold by society at good price. These societies are established to help small producers in selling their products. The society eliminates middlemen and helps its producers, members, to secure a good market for their products. The society takes care from packaging to warehousing and transporting so that the products can be sold at the best possible price. The profit earned from sale of products is distributed among members as per their individual contribution to the pool of output. So this is the marketing cooperative society established to help small producers. Okay? The next one is Farmers Cooperative Society. In this type of society, small farmers join together and pool their resources for cultivating their land collectively. Such societies provide better quality seeds, fertilizers, machinery, and other modern techniques for use in the cultivation of crops. It provides them opportunity of cultivation on large scale. So the main aim of farmers cooperative societies are formed by farmers with an aim to get better inputs at a reasonable cost. These societies provide individual farmers the benefits of large scale farming and hence increases productivity. These societies provide farmer members better quality seeds, fertilizers, machineries, and other modern techniques at a reasonable price. And the main aim of these societies is to provide directions to small farmers to improve production and get better returns. The next cooperative society is credit cooperative societies. Such societies protect the members from exploitation by money lenders. They provide loans to their members at easy terms and reasonably low rate of interest. Members of credit cooperative societies are all individuals who have difficulty in arranging credit and loans. These societies collect money from its members as capital or deposits and then use the same funds to provide loans to its members at very low interest rate. The main aim of credit cooperative societies is to protect its members from the exploitation of money lenders who charge very high rate of interest on loans. So these type of credit cooperative societies are established to provide financial assistance to its members at very reasonable terms. The next cooperative society is Cooperative Housing Society. The main aim is to provide houses to people with limited means or income at reasonable price. Cooperative housing societies are established to construct houses for its members at reasonable cost. Members of cooperative housing society pool in funds and acquire residential land and then either construct houses or provide plots to members so that they can construct house of their choice. Members of cooperative housing society have the options of paying in installments rather than lump sum investment. So these are the six types of cooperative societies. Now revise these all points and read about the joint stock company.